lies to every single story, the passion and the glory, just trying to make it through the day. You know we're trying to come together, arm in arm and hand in hand, and with my brother I will fight to unify our land. America, home of the brave, we stand strong when we're willing to change. And I will wash the feet of freedom and bow down on my knees, praying for a healing, fighting for the freedom of my brother and me. And on the other hand, there are those who would undo us, unruly, who would rule us and break us all apart. And I will stand beside you and fight against injustice and lawless ones among us. Come on, let freedom ring. America, home of the brave, we stand strong.
Didn't mean to do that, but I did it, so there it is, so here we are. Oh my goodness, I was trying to play with the settings, and I kind of boogered it up, but you know what, it doesn't look like anybody's actually here yet. Is anybody on the show? Because if you're not, I'll just go back to where I was. I'm the free world leader. Freedom's rolling out to you. Oh, let's roll.
Let's roll.
Well, I'm the good news instigator, compassionate conversator.
Hi, Taylor.
Rocking and rolling on out to you.
Hi, Patricia. Welcome to the John Morgan Show. I am your host. And we are a little bit early because I hit the button too soon. Someday we'll be, you know, like really professional, you know. Today is not that day. But I would rather be unprofessional and a man of integrity than have all the professionalism in the world and a wicked heart. Although, the best yet is to have all the professionalism in the world and a godly heart. And that's where we're headed on the John Morgan Show. We are getting better and better each and every day. That's right. Truth, justice, and the American way. So good to us. Ooh. Oh yeah. Yeah, baby. And just because I'm in the mood for it,
my fellow Americans, when hail rains down from the sky, it can ding your hood and dent your ride. I love my truck. I keep it looking good. So when I get a dent or a ding in the door, roof, or hood, I don't despair. I know the ding guy. When you're president, your image matters. You can't go around with dents and dings in your PR. That's DC lingo for presidential ride. So when you get a ding, just sing like a doorbell. Ding guy! And call 1-800-DING-GUY. The Ding Guy has been serving the great folks in Colorado Springs for decades. So don't delay. Dial 1-800-DING-GUY. Their fast, friendly, and reliable team of experts will get you restored faster than I can say nuclear strategery. So when some ding-dong dents your door, don't despair. Just dial the Ding Guy. 1-800-DING-GUY. Easy. Now that's strategery.
Hey, this is Al Robertson from Duck Dynasty and Duck Commander. I want to tell you about a great book called War on Fear from my good buddy, John Morgan. Of course, he looks like George W. Bush, who had the famous War on Terror, so I immediately knew, you know, there was a nice a bit of wordplay there. This book is fantastic. I think it speaks to sort of that natural fear that all of us have, whether it's public speaking or whether it's the first time you get asked to do something you've never done before, up to, you know, the fear of loss of life, of a sick person in your family, all the things that we face every single day. I recommend this highly. I promise you will be blessed when you read this book, and it's the sort of book that after you read it, you're going to want to pass that on to someone else, which to me are the best kind of books. So War on Fear, get yours as soon as you can.
Hey, welcome everybody to the John Morgan Show. A little bit of humor, a little bit of lighthearted love for your afternoon. Kind of think of it as an appetizer for your evening's meal. I am so honored to be with you today, and I love Superman. I really love American ideals. Don't you miss them? You know, I have some people that argue with me sometimes when I say that America needs to be restored to its greatness. And people act to me, they say, when was America great? When was America great? And I'll be honest with you. And they usually put it in terms of the black community. When was America great for the black community? Honestly, when I'm talking about American greatness, I'm talking about my experience, okay? I know that America has come from a place of slavery to a place of freedom for the black community. And it's happening yet again. And I appreciate the work of people like Candace Owens, who is shouting from the rooftops that people don't have to be bound in a victim mentality any longer, because they've been set free by the gospel. They've been set free. America is a land of opportunity. Yes, it's more complicated for some than others. Yes, it's more difficult for some than others. But do you know what's so great about the gospel? God gives us grace to help in our time of need, no matter who you are, no matter what your difficulty is. And you may have limitations. I promise you, I could set a goal right now, and I would never become an accountant. That will never happen. You know why? I was not gifted. I was not gifted with the aptitude or the desire to be a CPA or even a GPA, whatever that is. And so I don't have that capacity. But so it's great that God did not put the capacity in my heart to be a CPA or any of the three-letter words. Speaking of three-letter words, it's interesting to note that right now we are going through a season in our history where a lot of people are really questioning some of our three-letter agencies. And that brings me to what I want to talk about today. How much better to be a simple farmer or a simple Walmart greeter and have integrity in your heart and have a love for God and a love for your fellow man than to have all the money in China
and be a deviant and be a God hater and be a selfish, bigoted, prideful, envious, bitter, hating. Yeah, it just, no. Have you known people like that? They're just bitter. Everything's wrong. And their face, even their heart is all like that, all bound up. It's sad. Man, I have joy. I have joy. I have joy. Do you have joy today, friends? It has nothing to do with who's the mayor, who's the governor, who's the president, who's the emperor, whatever. I promise you, I would rather be a Christian in North Korea sitting in a communist prison than to live my life as a heathen in a New York City mansion. Knowing the Lord is everything because He frees your heart. He frees your soul. He gives you wings. And I'd like to know that you're my hero. You know, I will lose my male audience over what I'm about to say. But the first time I heard that song, I broke down and cried. I mean, I cried because I thought about my beautiful bride, Kathy, and how she rescued me. I thought about my sister, Janice, who to me is the queen of the world. She's my hero. And her love for God rescued me. They are my heroes. They are the wind beneath my wings. So yes, thank you, Bette Midler. You may not appreciate it, but you wrote a powerful song. To be an American with American freedom and American values, to stand up for what's right. You know, I'll tell you, I love my friends, like my friend Paul and other folks that I know that say, there's no evidence, drop it. Isn't it time to move on? When they themselves have heard the diabolical accusations made against the Democratic Party. And I say this every time, and I will say it as many times as I can remember to. I'm not throwing a blanket over Democrats. I'm throwing a blanket over the Democratic leadership that has allegedly committed voter fraud. Because if it is proven, there is no way you can say there's nothing to see here, folks. That song was sung at your mother's funeral, Karen. Oh, that is so awesome. That is so awesome. You know, the evidence, I mean, to say there's no evidence, how can you say that? When I mean, I respectfully ask the question, how can you say that when the allegations that have been made by people who say, who show you the stack of affidavits. Affidavits are evidence. First-person testimony from an eyewitness is evidence admissible in a court of law. You know that. I mean, that's why they protect eyewitnesses. Somebody witnessed a murder. They saw it. That testimony is evidence. And they have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, maybe even over 1,000 affidavits of people who saw voter fraud going down, so they claim. That's evidence, friends. And when it's presented in a court of law, that will be evidence. Some of it is available. You can look it up. Some of the affidavits, some of the really brave people who have been willing to face whatever firestorm hits them, that have made themselves public and their affidavits public, are there for you to look up and see. Absolute evidence. Now, why does the liberal, it used to be that the media were the watchdogs of society. Remember, there would be crimes committed, and what would they do? You'd see the reporters on the front yards, you know, asking the questions. Mr. Governor, is it true that blah, blah, blah? But why is it that the whole of the liberal media is going to say, move along, folks, there's no evidence, nothing to see. I mean, the talking points, they just repeat them, nothing to see. Come on, folks, open your eyes. I'm not saying that I know that any of the evidence is valid, because I haven't seen it. All I'm saying is there is evidence being claimed, hundreds and hundreds of articles of evidence. And every great American, liberal and Democrat, should want that evidence produced in a court of law, because great Americans on the left, great Americans on the right, great Americans in the middle, great Americans no matter what your affiliation, you should want the truth. The truth, the way, the truth, and the life. That's Christ. We want the truth, and I know you do too. You do too, because you're great Americans. And so let it play out. Let these folks who have worked so hard to defend our democracy, let them present their evidence and let it be judged so that we can all see it as Americans. And I have a friend, I have a lot of friends in the lookalike industry, really dear, wonderful, awesome friends. And one of my greatest friends that I admire and love with all my heart is a Bill Clinton impersonator. And he suggested on his Facebook page earlier, why aren't there cameras? Why isn't there video surveillance at all of these counting places? And I'm like, oh my gosh, why isn't there? Why wasn't there? I mean, right down the street from my house is a place that my mother would go almost every afternoon after work. The Veterans Thrift. The Veterans Thrift. Oh, man, treasure. Talk about treasure hunting. You get so many cool stuff from there. And most of what I wear came from there, to be honest with you. Or some kind of deal I made. But they have cameras shining straight down on the transactions. And everything that's sold, the people, they've got to put the merchandise up there so the camera can record it. Then they've got to put the money up there so the camera can record it. And then they hand you your receipt. And it's all on video. So there's no reason to be tempted to steal, because you're going to get caught. You absolutely know you're going to get caught because every transaction is recorded. Well, I say that we as Americans insist, not the vote, because you know your vote needs to be private, but everything else is video recorded, so that there's no possible way that all of the voter fraud that has taken place can take place. Yes, we need to have the eyewitness, Republican, Democrat, verification, all of which many, many affidavits have been sworn to was prevented in this particular election, that Republicans in these major cities were kept a long ways off so they couldn't witness what was going down. Yeah, Karen, casinos do it. Absolutely. We need videographic evidence in any future elections. That needs to become law. Don't you agree? Do y'all want me to spearhead the? We'll get it on the ballot for the state of Florida, and then we'll find. I mean, this should be a major push that we need to do everything that we can to make sure that voter fraud does not happen in states. And oh, look at all the hearts. Yeah, you agree. It's like, I can't believe I thought of it because it's a no-brainer. No, I didn't think of it. My friend Tim thought of it. Tim Waters, he thought of it, and I looked at it and I went, yeah, this makes perfect sense. It's exactly what we should do. But friends, I want to get back. I want to finish up today talking about the simplicity of love. The simplicity of freedom, of loving God, loving one another, of lending a hand when it's needed, of giving to organizations like Compassion International, whose sole reason for existing is to feed and clothe the hungry around the world and to bring the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We all need to be supporting the poor. That's the thing. You know, in Matthew, when they at the end of time, when they separate the sheep from the goats, Jesus is going to open the book of life, and he's going to look for your name, and he's going to see it there. And then he's going to say, welcome into heaven. Welcome to your eternal reward. For I was hungry, and you fed me. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you visited me. You prayed for me. I was in prison and you came to see me. And many will say, but Lord, when were you sick? Come on, and we visit. When were you naked and we clothed you? When were you hungry and we fed you? And you know what he'll say? Whenever you did it to the least of these, my brothers, you did it unto me. We talk a lot on this show about Christ. He's in here. The God of the universe. If you want to know where he is, right here. He's in me. If you want to see him, he's inside here. The window of my soul is right here. Look in, and you'll see the Lord. You'll see his love shining through. That's America. That's freedom, real freedom. And those who would just do evil. It's so sad. How can they enjoy? They may live in a mansion. They may have power. How's their heart? How's their soul? So anyway, I wanted to end with a song because I'm just in the mood. And it really is a beautiful, beautiful ballad written by, I think, America's most romantic singer-songwriter. Maybe in history. I don't know. I'm sure there are others. But this guy is the top of the chain, James Taylor. When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care, and nothing, oh, nothing's going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up
even the darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh, yes, I will, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Oops. You got a friend. When the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud. Now and soon I'll be knocking upon your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll go running, running, baby, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Hey, ain't it good to know that you got a friend, when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you and desert you, oh, well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Oh yeah, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh, yes, I will, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, hey, now all you gotta do, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. You got a friend, hey baby, you got a friend. Now mama, you got a friend. Ain't it good to know, ain't it good to know, ain't it good to know, no, no, now you got a friend.
Oh, reminds me of being on the senior dock back at Bishop Moore. 1974, baby. You know, I ought to write a song called 1974. I don't think it exists. That needs to happen. Well, folks, thank you for tuning into the John Morgan Show. Simplicity, love, kindness, all the things that really make America great. Loyalty. Yeah. Thank you, Karen. You're beautiful too. Well, Lord, I pray a blessing over all my friends, over my loved ones. I pray that you will heal Andy, my friend from church. I pray that you will heal Karen. I pray that you will heal Diane. I pray, God, that you will heal my sister Janice, totally restore my brother Joel, and everybody that's on your heart. Jeff, congratulations on your new puppy dog. Everybody, oh, have a magnificent night. And keep praying for the president. Keep praying that the truth will come out, no matter what it is, that the evidence will be presented and a verdict will be rendered, and that all of America will know the truth, and the truth will set us free. Thank you for tuning into the John Morgan Show. I love you. I appreciate you. Have an excellent, excellent afternoon. And we'll see you tomorrow morning at 5 a.m. for Pray for America.
free world leader. Freedom's rolling out to you.
Let's roll.
Well, I'm the good news instigator, compassionate conversator. This freedom is rocking and rolling on out to you. Red, white, and blue.
Thanks so much for watching the John Morgan Show, folks. I appreciate you so much. Keep up your courage. Keep up your love. And keep believing for great things. Patricia, that was a ukulele. That was a typical, wonderful little Hawaiian ukulele. Yep, some nice picking, huh? I'll never be a CPA, but I was gifted with a gift for music. 1974, that's going to be an awesome song. Maybe I'll start writing it tonight. Gonna have to have some Phil Keaggy guitars on it. Oh yeah. Oh, keep the home fires burning, folks. Look at that Motley Crue in there. Former presidents. I'm not ready for Donald Trump to be a former president. How about you? Thank you, Patricia. You're an accountant. God bless you. I honor you. I can't even fathom it. All right. Love you too, Linda. Love you all. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America.